Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to talk about the new floating point types that were added in C++ 23. I know that some of you say, well, I could have just gotten this information with a link to the Wikipedia article or something like that. But the fact is, many of you have not even heard of this thing, so you don't know that you need to go and look for that article, but I'll try to provide a little bit more value than just this CPP reference page that I'm looking at right now. Before I continue, I do want to remind you both that I have C++ best practices books, including a C++ 23 update and a series of C++ puzzle books, and also that I will be doing a C++ best practices workshop at NDC Tech Town in the beginning of September of 2024. Be sure to check that out. There will be a link to it in this video description. So C++ 23 added new floating point types, including fixed width descriptions of these types. Now, this is fascinating, first of all, because this is the first time we've ever had 16-bit floating point types in the C++ standard. And this could actually matter to you if you do work on small devices. But there's another interesting thing called bfloat, and there's the fact that we've never had sized types before. So first of all, these things are optional by the standard. And second of all, you have to include this standard float header to get them. Now, you might know that float tends to be 32 bits, double is 64 bits, and long double is 128 bits, or something along those lines. But we've never had a way of actually guaranteeing this in the standard. We just had to kind of know that on our platform, float, double, and long double were these things. So I've got a 4-byte float, I've got an 8-byte double, and I have a 16-byte long double. With this new change in C++ 23, we can say float 32t. And know that we mean the 32-bit 4-byte version, or we can say float 64t and get the equivalent of a double, or float 128t. So that is the first thing that this gives us. So do be aware that these things might actually vary from platform to platform, but this is what we have. We have sized specific floating point numbers. The new thing that we have is float 16t, which is the 2-byte 16-bit version, and that's brand new. We've never had anything like this before, and bfloat 16. If you do any work with machine learning, then you might be aware of bfloat, and this is, unexpectedly to me, short for brain float. And the point is that it shifts the mantissa and the exponent values inside the floating point layout so that we get to optimize for machine learning-like things, because we can process more 16-bit floats on GPU hardware than you can 32-bit floats, and you want a certain range that makes sense for machine learning applications. Okay, if we go back to our CPP reference page, it does actually specifically say 11 bits of precision, 5 bits of exponent for float 16, and we have it split evenly, 8 bits of precision and 8 bits of exponent for bfloat 16. These other things are actually required because they are part of the IEEE floating point standards. And you'll note that this bfloat 16 has no equivalence at all in the C standard. So to help us play with this, I've actually made a little example that helps us actually look at what these values would be. You can pass in a series of bits, and these will be cast respectively to the float 16, the bfloat 16, and we can explore the different values that they will actually represent. So go ahead and check out the link to this that will be available through the video description and play with it yourself. And you can see the binary, hex, and decimal representations of the value that was passed in, as well as the floating point representation, the normal float 16 that we know, versus the bfloat 16 representation of this. So hopefully this relatively short episode was interesting to you and you learned that there is a thing called a brain float. Be sure to dig more into this if you have any interest in it at all, and subscribe and leave this video a thumbs up, and thank you for watching.